Cardiac tamponade is a life-threatening situation in which fluid within the pericardial cavity compresses the heart, preventing its filling during diastole. Normally, there could be a thin layer of fluid, about 20 to 50 ml in the pericardial cavity. When fluid accumulates gradually in the pericardium due to a slow disease process, the parietal pericardium stretches to accommodate more fluid in the range of 500 ml. But rapid collection of fluid, as in the case of bleeding into the pericardial cavity, is less tolerated, and features of tamponade and hemodynamic collapse may develop with as little as 100 ml of pericardial fluid. Causes of cardiac tamponade. Any cause for rapid collection of fluid in the pericardial cavity can cause tamponade. By and large, malignant effusion is probably the most important cause of cardiac tamponade, with large collections of hemorrhagic pericardial effusion. Traumatic cardiac tamponade can occur with any injury involving the heart. Proximal aortic dissection can leak into the pericardial cavity and cause hemorrhagic pericardial effusion and tamponade. Tuberculous pericardial effusion can also cause cardiac tamponade, though less dramatic than in case of a hemorrhagic pericardial effusion. Tuberculous pericardial effusion can sometimes be hemorrhagic as well. Interventional procedure-related cardiac tamponade is now being managed in the cardiac catheterization laboratory in fair numbers. Coronary perfusion can occur during percutaneous interventions causing pericardial tamponade. Procedures involving atrial septal punctures like balloon mitral valvotomy and ablation of atrial fibrillation in left atrium carry a risk of cardiac perforation and tamponade. Even simple right heart catheterization can result in cardiac tamponade, especially when manipulating relatively stiff catheters at the vulnerable inferior vena cava right atrial junction. Cases are on record in which both temporary and permanent pacing leads have perforated the right ventricle. Temporary pacemaker leads are more likely to cause perforation as they are stiffer. Clinical findings. Beck's compression triad is a combination of hypotension, distended neck veins, and muffled heart sounds. Pulsus paradoxus is another classic finding. ECG showing electrical alternance in large pericardial effusion with a swinging heart. Alternating QRS voltage is very evident in V1. Low voltage QRS complexes are also seen. Alternance in P, QRS and T wave amplitudes is called as electrical alternance totalis or total electrical alternance, which is considered as diagnostic of large pericardial effusion. This echocardiogram shows the heart swinging in the pericardial cavity with large pericardial effusion. Classical sign of tamponade on echocardiography is the diastolic collapse of right atrium and right ventricle, which prevents adequate filling of the heart. Management of cardiac tamponade is by immediate pericardiocentesis. In an emergency situation, urgent bedside aspiration may be life-saving. Pericardiocentesis under fluoroscopic guidance is more often resorted to these days, unlike the direct bedside aspiration of the yesteryears. The pericardial space is usually approached from the subxiphoid route and standard Seldinger technique, with initial needle puncture followed by guide wire introduction is usual. Once the guide wire position has been confirmed, an arterial sheath is introduced over the guide wire. A pigtail catheter introduced through the sheath is used for therapeutic pericardial aspiration. If recollection is expected, the pigtail can be left there in situ for a few days for follow-up bedside aspiration with all aseptic precautions. In case of large periprocedural hemorrhagic pericardial effusion, it is usual practice to auto-transfuse the blood drained into the circulation using a three-way adapter. This reduces the blood loss in an emergency and buys time while the patient is being shifted for surgical repair of the periprocedural perforation. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.